the lecture now is about the differential diagnosis of vertigo from the point of history approach. اتكلمنا المرتين اللي فاتوا على البيت سايد فيستيبلر اسسمنت بيت سايد فيستيبلر اسسمنت اند ستيل ذير از هيوج اند بيج بارت اوف ذا اسسمنت اوف ذا فيستيبلر disorder patient which is the history. The history in combination with the bedside vestibular assessment contributes to 70 to 80% of your way to diagnosis. Second, your history together with your bedside assessment is your road to assess the functional disability present in the patient, the patient's own perception of his own problem, and your gate for the rehabilitation plan you are heading. Okay, so history approach is a very important aspect in the diagnosis of vestibular disorder patient. As a start, balance disorder, of course you all know, a disturbance that causes an individual to feel unsteady, giddy, woozy, or have a sensation of movement, spinning, or floating. All these words, كل الكلمات دي بتعبر عن sensation of unsteadiness in some sort, imbalance in some sort, disequilibrium, disorientation. All these terms are used by the patient interchangeably to describe a sensation which sometimes is well defined and in many times it is ill defined. Of course, each one of you in the environment he lives in will hear another terms, many terms, according to the culture of the patient he deals with. Okay, woozy, have sensation of movement, spinning, or float. These are the complaints about the balance disorder. Of course, the control of body balance contributes to systems, many systems, the vestibular system, the visual system, and deep sensation of global receptive system, the muscles, the joints, and the skin, under the control of the central nervous system or the coordination of the integration, which controls the eye movement and postural control by muscle, to attain the final result, which is the balance. Balance dysfunction is which we call imbalance or dizziness. So the word dizziness is the broad term of any complaint mentioned by the patient to describe abnormality imbalance. Abnormality, the dizziness is the broad term. Okay. In the way of the diagnosis, we are taking our history, we will pass through these steps. The first step is the complaint. The complaint of the patient, you have to write it as the patient said it exactly in the patient's own words. Okay, a first item is the complaint. You have to take your time with the patient to see the عيان يتكلم زي ما هو عايز. The complaint بالطريقة اللي تريحه. The patient own word. If you are in a hurry, don't take history for a vestibular disorder patient. You have to be patient. You have to take your time. You have to listen carefully to the patient until he finishes what he is seeking you for. The second item is the temporal profile. Temporal profile is the timing of the attack. Is it attack? Is it persistent symptom? Okay, and so on. The third item is the head and the body position. Is there any provocating position? Are there any associated symptoms? What about the past history and what about the medications? So these are the items who will cover during history take. Right. The complaint here is your gate to describe the type of business. When you listen carefully to the patient, you will diagnose the type of business the patient is complaining from. Is it vertigo? Is it breathing cough? Is it disequilibrium? Or other types of business, vague, which is difficult to describe, like floating a feeling of dissociation. Take care when you are dealing with patients from another culture, you will hear difficult to describe and weird words describing the complaint. You have to put your lines to differentiate these words and track each one under the category. You know, is it vertigo, is it brisingcope, is it disequilibrium, is it other types, okay? If the first item you will cover is the type of business. What is the type of business you are facing? The patient often complains of dizziness, giddiness, which is vague term and may not always mean vertigo. مش لازم في كل الأحوال يعني إن ده vertigo. Most dizzy patients can be placed into one of four categories. The four major categories of dizziness, under which most of the patients, 90%, 80%, 75% of patients will be listed below, are the true vertigo in 50% of cases, the brisingcope, the disequilibrium category, and the vague lightheadedness. Vague lightheadedness. Okay? These are the four major complaints you will face. We will leave vertigo, which is our major complaint or our main issue, to be the last one to talk about. The brisingcope is a transient sensation. Transient is, take care, it is a transient, it is not a persistent sensation. It is a transient sensation that a faint is about to occur, as someone were about to pass out. May present as nausea, weakness, or change of vision. The patient may describe double vision, not oslopsia. Blurring of vision, not oslopsia. Okay? Nausea, no vomiting, weakness. The patient is describing as I was about to pass out. Due to diffuse, usually this complaint is due to diffuse cerebellar ischemia. The main offending issue here is diffuse cerebral ischemia. Diffuse cerebral ischemia. Typically arising from vascular or cardiac causes. So if a patient has a history of cardiac surgery, if a patient has a history of vascular strokes, if a patient has a history of atherosclerosis or hypertension or hypotension, you may face this brisingcope. Common causes include vasovagal episodes, postural hypotension with cardiac, such as the arrhythmias with chronic heart failure, a low output, a cardiac conditions with carotid sinus sensitivity. These are common causes of brisingcope. What are the common causes? It is not vestibular. Okay, common causes, they are not vestibular. The brisingcope complaint is not vestibular. It is usually due to cardiovascular problem. It is a vascular problem, okay? Usually diffuse cerebral ischemia. You have to put your line under the complaint that describes the brisingcope. The patient may have fainting or about to faint. It is not a drop attack. Not the drop attack of Meniere, the Meniere crisis, not this attack. Okay, the patient has nausea. The patient feels weak. The patient may report changes in vision, like blurring of vision. Okay, these are the transient sensation of fainting, what we call the brisingcope. It is of vascular cause. The vague lightheadedness. This is a vague lightheadedness, and the complaint itself is vague. The head discomfort is due to either psychiatric disorder, hyperventilation syndrome, or encephalopathy. It is not vestibular also. It is not vestibular also. Okay? A vague lightheadedness is the second complaint, which is a vague symptom. The patient cannot describe what exactly he feels. It is usually, or maybe, not usually, or due to psychiatric disorders, due to hyperventilation syndrome, or encephalopathy in the most serious condition, encephalopathy. The next complaint is disequilibrium. This is a common complaint in the elderly. Disequilibrium is a loss of balance. Unsteadiness. The patient cannot stand still on his foot. Off balance. Mostly felt in the lower limb. Mostly, العيان بيشتكي إنها في lower limb. Prominent when standing or walking. So the patient, as long as he is sleeping in bed or sitting in his chair, there is no complaint. The complaint starts when the patient is on his feet. Relieved by sitting or lying down. There is no abnormal sense of motion. No spinning, no oscillopsia, no other these complaints. No sense of faintness. Okay, but this is the disequilibrium complaint, which is loss of balance. The patient describes unsteadiness. It appears mostly when the patient stands and is relieved by sitting or lying down. Disequilibrium perceived as body rather than head sensation. Arising from the motor control system, the vision, the vestibular spinal, proprioceptive, sensorocerebellar or motor function. Common causes include stroke, sensory deficits, severe vestibular loss of peripheral neuropathy, and cerebellar disease. Okay, this is the disequilibrium. Other types of dizziness may see vaguely described and may be associated with anxiety and other psychological disorders, or with older person often describe several subtypes. An older person, you may have vestibular neuritis with disequilibrium due to cerebellar ischemia. You may have a bracing cob with the super added benign paroxysmal. So you may see a mix of complaints. Most patients have this equilibrium along with some other types of dizziness, vertigo or bracing cob. The cardinal symptom of our vestibular system is vertigo. Before we go with vertigo, we see this slide. Vague complaints common in younger person, female younger person than in older person, describe floating or feeling of dissociation, inability to concentrate, inability to be involved in a long time task, and associated with an exciting psychological disorder mostly seen in younger ages. Vertigo is a Latin word. It means to turn with a suffix ego, which is a condition of turning about, a move nearly to turn or turning about. The vertigo is a subtype of dizziness. The vertigo is a subtype of dizziness. Initial dizziness is a subtype of vertigo. A broad term, the broad term is the dizziness. The vertigo is the subtype of dizziness, which entitles the illusion of movement. The patient here is assuming he is moving, or the environment around him is moving. Illusion of movement of either one's self or one's environment. It doesn't matter which one. It is a cardinal symptom of vestibular disorder. Loss of balance plus abnormal sense of motion between patient and the surrounding. It constitutes loss of balance plus abnormal sensation of motion. So the first item in your history is to verify the patient complaint. Is it vertigo or not? If vertigo, identify which type of vertigo. After you identify which type of vertigo, establish the diagnosis and the etiology. And the last item is to plan for therapy. If it is not vertigo from the start, to go for headache, stress, or other types of dizziness. As the first item of the first, you will get to the assessment of the patient is the complaint, is to specify whether it is vertigo or not. Okay. The temporal pattern of symptoms, is it continuous? Patient describes that he has a continuous sensation of imbalance, continuous sensation of spinning, continuous sensation of loss of his body control. This continuous pattern of symptoms usually is due to psychological problem, medication problem, patient has vestibular toxic drugs, permanent structural damage, like patient after a stroke or cerebellar atrophy, or vestibular damage, major vestibular damage, peripheral neuropathy, or deconditioning. The patient diagnosed previously with peripheral vestibular lesion, and he was compensated, and this deconditioning occurred due to some any reason. Okay, where this continuous pattern of symptom has its differential diagnosis between psychological medication and the central causes of severe vestibular damage. The one we care about is the episodic nature of symptom. You have to declare that the patient has continuous symptom or episodes. Sometimes a patient cannot differentiate between episodes with in between episodes, not free interval. He is not well in between attacks. So he describes it as continuous, which is not true. The true continuous sensation is a sensation which does not fluctuate along the time of period. But episodic attacks is attack, well-described attack, has its well-described duration. which disappear and reappear after a specified period of time. In between, the patient may be free or may be not good. يبقى الإبيزوديك ده عادة بنشوفه مع عيانين in benign paroxysmal positional vertigo, of course, recurrent vestibulopathy, TIAs, meniere's, أو المجرين. These differential diagnoses or these causes, we are not heading for describing this. We are not heading for describing this continuous versus episodic. How you attain your description, your accurate description from your patient. يبقى أول حاجة اتكلمنا على الكومبلين إن أنا أعرف من العيان الكومبلين بتاعته ديت عبارة عن إيه بالظبط؟ هل هي ديزنس أي صوت ديزنس اللي قلناهم ولا هي فيرتيجو؟ تاني حاجة هل الفيرتيجو ده كونتينيوس ولا إبيزوديك؟ نمبر 1 التايب أوف ذا كومبلين إز إت فيرتيجو أور نوت؟ نمبر 2 ذا تمبورال باتر إز إت إبيزوديك أور نوت؟ تيك كير دونت تيك ذا بيشنت إنتو وات يو آر ثينكينج أوف. Let the patient talk freely to describe his complaint. Listen carefully and be patient. Okay? Take care that the patient may have double pathology. Patient with vestibular neuritis with long history of vestibular suppressant drugs will turn into chronic patient. Chronic patient may have psychiatric symptoms which may take your mind into a psychiatric type of vertigo, which is not the true. It is a true vertigo of vestibular origin with super added psychiatric sequelae due to poor management from the start. Okay? Double pathology is ever there. Double pathology is ever there. So let the patient talk freely. Avoid. Leading a question during the patient, he is describing his symptoms. Don't ask the patient, do you feel spinning? Do you feel imbalance? Do you feel fainting? No. Let the patient talk. If you see that the patient is talking with no specific nature or description for his complaint, try to modify your question in order to specify this complaint more clearly. Do you have this or that? Do you have this or that? Make the patient choose. Don't make the patient say yes or no. All the answers would be yes, and you will be lost. Or no, and you will be lost also. Let the patient choose. Don't let the patient say yes or no. The second thing to important to describe is it continuous, really continuous or episodic. The patient, اللي جاله vestibular neuritis من شهرين, 2 months ago, vestibular neuritis lasted 2 or 3 days, will describe continuous sensation up till now based on his sense of spinning with head movement or neck movement. He will not differentiate between the attack, which is off 2 months ago, and the sequelae of attack due to poor compensation, which occurs nowadays with head or neck movement. Okay? The second item to look for is the temporal pattern of symptoms. Is it continuous or episodic? Is it acute versus chronic? The acute is well defined, the isolated spell of vertigo with distinct onset and offset, resolved in 2 weeks. The chronic vertigo is persistent or chronic sensation or recurrent. The patient has persistent or chronic sensation over a longer period of time, or the other chronic type is a patient with recurrent sensation of vertigo. Is it acute or chronic? Will define the isolated spell or persistent or chronic sensation. The third item, the associated symptom. It is very important. Associated symptoms will differentiate peripheral from central vertigo. How come? The peripheral vertigo is usually of sudden onset. Whenever the central vertigo is of gradual onset, the peripheral vertigo will be intermittent with severe symptoms. The nausea or vomiting will be severe. The spinning is severe. The attack is intermittent. Central vertigo is constant sensation of milder symptoms, slight dizziness over a long period of time. If improved, it will not disappear. and it may show short periods of slight improvement, but not disappear. If a constant was milder symptom, the peripheral vertigo is usually affected by head position and the movement. في بقى associated symptom هنا أو provocating symptom هنا العيان will report إن هو إيه may provoke the attack or may exacerbate the attack with head position, head movement or eye movement. However, central vertigo is usually not affected by head position or movement. Nausea and vomiting are more frequent and severe with peripheral vertigo, while they are less predictable and less presented with central vertigo. The motor functions, gait, and the coordination are typically intact in peripheral vertigo. With central vertigo, the motor function, the gait, the instability, and loss of coordination are frequent. طبعا احنا اتكلمنا عن bedside vestibular assessment we describe the gait thoroughly and we say how to examine the gait of the patient, how you recognize abnormal gait from ever patient is opening the door and entering your place. Okay, the associated symptom will differentiate peripheral from central vertigo. Again, nystagmus with peripheral vertigo, this is a comparison between peripheral or central, but nystagmus is not a symptom, it is a sign. Imbalance with peripheral vertigo would be mild to moderate, with a patient able to walk. However, with central vertigo, usually the imbalance is severe, the patient is unable to stand or walk. Associated symptoms with peripheral vertigo, hearing loss and tinnitus are usually common, while with central vertigo, there is no hearing loss or tinnitus, sometimes. Neurological symptoms are typically absent with peripheral vertigo, with central vertigo are common. The peripheral vertigo has a latency after provocation, while central vertigo latency is shorter after provocation. If there is provocative factor, it would be shorter to occur after this provocation, up to 5 seconds. If associated symptom, how it would differentiate peripheral from central vertigo, where you are taking the history of the patient. Number four, the duration of the attack. How long the attack lasts? It will go into the differential diagnosis as well. Duration of vertigo, we have categories, major categories. Vertigo lasting seconds, vertigo lasting hours, vertigo lasting days, vertigo lasting for months. Is there vertigo lasting for months? Yes, there is. Duration of vertigo, when vertigo lasts for seconds, it will go to the previous slide. Is there auditory symptoms present, associated auditory symptoms present or not? If there is auditory symptoms present, if the vertigo which lasts for seconds, that may be. الحاجات دي كلها مش 100% may be brachiopathic fistula. But if auditory symptoms are absent, it may be benign paroxysmal dorsal vertigo or BBI, vertebral basal insufficiency or cervical vertigo. Type. If the duration of vertigo lasts for hours with auditory symptoms present, you are talking for mostly for endolymphatic hydrosis or Meniere's disease. طبعا Meniere's disease minutes to hours. من minutes 15 to 30 minutes and may last to 24 hours. Or if auditory symptoms are not present, you are dealing with maybe recurrent vestibulopathy or vestibular migraine. Vertigo lasting for days with auditory symptoms present, you have labyrinthitis or labyrinthine concussion. Auditory symptoms present. Vestibular neuritis has no auditory symptoms, no hearing loss with the patient with vestibular neuritis. The last category, vertigo lasting for months, is with acoustic neuroma or ototoxicity. Ototoxicity, طبعا كامل vestibulopathy, lasts for months. If auditory symptoms are absent, you have maybe multiple sclerosis or cerebellar degeneration. I'll complain. Type of dizziness present. Is it vertigo or not? The temporal characteristic. Is it continuous sensation or attacks? Is it acute attack or chronic attacks? Chronic vertigo. Okay. The number three are the associated symptoms. Number four, the duration of the attack. Okay. As you see, the combination duration with the associated symptoms, you have differential diagnosis, kaza or kaza or kaza. Duration with the no auditory symptom, you have kaza or kaza or kaza. Duration with type of complaint, okay? So this differential diagnosis has to go and go and show in your head many times, many times, many times in order to be written in its right order. Again, many ears lasting for minutes to hours, hearing loss with tinnitus or oral fullness. So nine paroxysmal seconds, no hearing loss, tinnitus, no oral fullness, no tinnitus. Vestibular neuritis days to weeks, no any other complaint. Acoustic neuroma, usually imbalance with progressive or poor speech discrimination. This is another differential diagnosis based on the duration of attack or associated symptoms. What are common problems we meet with aging? Great sway during the platform studies with known loss of hair and semicircular canals will applicable with secure of vestibular cell aging. Then presbyosis occurs in auditory symptom and presbystasis occurs with vestibular symptom. Progressive decline for baroreflex sensitivity. Baroreflex is this reflex which regulates the blood circulation during a changing body position. So elderly may explore or complain from hypertension, hypotension is more than younger ages. This baroreflex or baroreceptor reflex is one of the body's homeostatic mechanisms that help to maintain blood pressure at nearly constant level. The baroreflex provides a rapid negative feedback loop in which an elevated blood pressure reflexively causes the heart rate to decrease and also causing blood pressure to decrease. الريفلكس ده ديفكتيف في بارو ريفلكس هو اللي بيؤدي الى حالات الاورثوستاتيك هايبوتنشن ذات اوكيرز موستلي وذ اولدر ايجز اند سام تايمز ان يانجر ايجز اسوشيتد وذ انيميا اور هايبوتنشن اور اسوشيتد وذ ميديكيشن. This is the scheme, the last scheme, business. Is it regulatory vertigo or no? If no, it is bracing cope disequilibrium or lightheadedness. If yes, through vertigo, you have red flags suggesting a brain stem stroke or other central causes. If the patient has neurological symptoms or signs, if the patient has acute deafness, if new type or new onset headache, if vertical nystagmus. If not vertigo, if no red flags, no do confirmatory test role in benign positional vertigo, the bike maneuver or acute vestibular neuritis, or the head thrust test. Okay, and go if the maneuver I did. بوزيتيف يبقى انا بناين بروجريسمال جو فور مانجمنت. لو لقيت النستاجماس ساستيند فيرتيجو اند هوريزونتال نستاجماس نوت بوزيشنال مع الهيد تراست تيست فيلير اوف فيستيبولار اوكيلار ريفلكس ده اكيوت فيستيبولار نيورايتس. لو انا ما لقيتش بقى حاجه في البوزيشنال ديت ولا في الهيد تراست كونسيدر فيستيبولار مايريل او ترانزيانت يونيلاترال هيرنج لوس او كونسيدر مينير ديسيز او روتين ريفير. طب تمام طلعنا بيها من المحاضره دي. طبعا احنا كده ايه خلصنا شيكسبير هو جزء صغير ناخده كده كلمتين في السريع بقى الهنتات او الهنتس اللي بتيجي مع العيانين ونحن بنشتغل. اول هنت ان العيان لازم يقول الكلمتين اللي هو هيقولهم كلهم وبعد كده حضرتك تتدخل بالاسئله بتاعتك عشان تعدل الكلام ده بما يضمن ان انت تاخد الكومبلين اللي حضرتك هتحطها في الديفرنشال دايجنوزس عشان تبقى متوضبه مع بقيه الشيت اللي هتاخده. يعني ما سيبش العيان يقول لي انا بقى اقع وما اعرفش هو ده عباره عن اورثوستاتيك هايبوتنشن ولا دروب اتاك ولا تمام. طبعا في حاجات ثانيه في الهيستوري بنزودها غير السلايز دي زي if the patient complains of drop attack the patient frequent fall whether the patient is old age or not you have to ask about consciousness during the fall do you lose consciousness ask the patient to ask and ask a relative a relative who witnessed the fall. Does the patient lose consciousness during the falling or the patient stay conscious until he reaches the ground? Because it will differentiate the drop attack due to cardiac problem or drop attack due to tumor king crisis or atypical meniere. The patient with atypical meniere drops like a stone with no loss of consciousness. Once he touches the ground, he can stand by his own without assistance. Okay? في ايه تاني اقدر اسال عليه؟ Of course, medical history بتاع العيان is very important. The patient with old age, with history of stroke, with history of hyperlipidemia, with history of atherosclerosis is more prone to brainstem infarctions, which زي ما قلنا ال infarction of ICA or BICA, البونتو ميدالري او اللاترال ميدالري سيندروم. Okay, the patient in this category, you have to take the history carefully in order to proceed with your bedside to exclude major problems like BICA or ICA infarction syndrome. Okay, what else? If the patient recorded or reported this vertigo during exercise of the upper extremity, this will lead you to diagnose of cervical vertigo or transient ischemic attack or vertebral bundle insufficiency. Exercises in the upper limbs, or when I rise my hand over my head, when I raise my head to look up or something like that, you may think of vertebral bundle insufficiency. What if patient with diabetes, peripheral neuropathy, okay? Patient with history of prolonged bed rest, history of strokes or thrombi or emboli, okay? You have to ask the patient all these questions, and if he has a relative with him, you have to ask his relative how the patient looks like when he is in the attack. The relative may report something the patient did not see or did not recognize during the attack. Okay, the history. Be patient with your patient. Don't تطلع من الهيستوري بحاجتين ثلاثة. تمام؟ أو حاجتين. أنت داخل على كده على bedside examination عشان exclude one and confirm the other. Okay, to exclude one of the two possibilities you had in your mind, exclude one of them or confirm the other. Or confirm one of them. Okay, the history is your key to your diagnosis. Is your key to your diagnosis. After that, your bedside examination is the gate to your diagnosis. And after that, the laboratory examination is your documentation of your already. The prescribed diagnosis, okay? Don't exclude double pathologies, patient of the age with cerebellar ischemia and the benign paroxysmal positional vertigo of the age. Patient with previous history of vestibular arthritis, long duration ago, with new attack of trauma resulted in benign paroxysmal positional vertigo, or head trauma, or surgical trauma, عملت بريدين في فيستولا. Double pathologies are usually there. The patient with hypotension is difficult to be compensated. And after attack of vestibular neuritis, he will experience vertigo with the head and neck movement for a long time. If he has hypotension together with this problem, okay? Patient with long-standing vestibular suppressant drug will never compensate, and you will have this chronic patient going for long duration complaining of this type of bad sensation of dizziness, which may not be vertigo anymore, dizziness with head movement or with eye movement. History and history is very important, and thank you.